lagi. Kita hari ini mau ke Karimunjawa. Dan perjalanan hari ini kita mau berhenti dulu di kota Solo lewat tol. Dan setelah dari Solo nanti kita ke Jepara. Dan setelah dari Jepara, besoknya pagi-pagi kita tes antigen dulu. Lalu kita naik speedboat ke Karimunjawa. Ayo!
As usual, we are starting our journey in Malang. It's about a 4-hour drive to Solo, which is our halfway stop. After a good night's sleep in Solo, we continue for another 3.5 hours to Jepara. Jepara is known for Javanese teak wood carving art, as well as being the birthplace of Kartini. Although you can take a slow ferry to the islands, which will take you about 5 hours, we chose to travel with the express Bahari speedboat. The fast boat takes about 2 hours to cross the 83 kilometer distance. Karimunjawa is an Indonesian chain of 27 islands in the Java Sea between Java and Borneo. It's known for the Karimunjawa National Park, a marine conservation area with mangrove forests, beaches and coral reefs. The islands are considered to be Java's tropical paradise. The best time to visit the islands is during the dry season, generally speaking from April to October. The main activities on Karimunjawa are snorkeling, diving and cruising around on a motorbike to explore the town, the mangrove and the innumerable deserted white sand beaches. Accommodation ranges from budget places to specialty lodgings, such as huts as well as homestays and motels. During our trip, we stayed at the Legon Baru Cottages Resort, with a phenomenal room overlooking a private beach. This hotel is very close to town but still offers privacy and delivers a high standard of service for a very reasonable price. Snorkeling is usually done by either arranging a boat through your hotel or heading down to the dock to find a local fisherman willing to take you out. Since I have my license, I like to go diving. This time organized by Salma Dive Shop. Around the islands offers beautiful coral reefs and some shipwrecks. Today I will be diving at the famous Indonor, a steamship of 99 meters long and 12 meters high, which sunk in February 1960. Huge steel plates and riveted steam boilers are home to many species of reef fish. However, diving into this wreck is not recommended for beginning divers because the compartments are narrow and dark. But there's more than just snorkeling and diving. A half an hour motorcycle ride away from town, we can join a mangrove trekking tour. Mangrove trekking is a mangrove forest managed by the Karimunjawa National Park Office. In this place, visitors can walk on wooden pathways while enjoying and learning about some rare species. Bukit Love is a popular sunset viewpoint and photo spot, with a love statue, vistas of the coast, and a small cafe. Island hopping tours can be organized, which take visitors to the neighboring islands such as Jepara, Manjangan, and Galea. If you're feeling a bit adventurous, head on over to Manjangan Island. As many sharks have been sighted around the Karimunjawa Islands, this has become a tourist attraction. Swimming with the sharks is a must-try activity here. There are many things to do here, and the Karimunjawa people create a very relaxed and super friendly atmosphere. This is definitely one of the places in the world we would like to come back to more than once.
Unfortunately.